In this tutorial, I'm gonna start by setting up a username and a password on a MongoDB database. And next, I'm gonna write a command prompt Java application that allows the user to authenticate to that MongoDB database. And also, it's gonna allow the user to insert JSON data and find and display all records. I'll start by creating a new project. I'm gonna call it MongoDB project 02. And here I'm gonna drop the MongoDB driver that I downloaded earlier, and set up the Java build path. And I'm gonna create a Java class I'm gonna call driver, and it's gonna be in this package. It's gonna have a main method. Now, in the previous tutorial, I had downloaded MongoDB and unzipped it to this directory. So I have the bin directory here for MongoDB. And for this tutorial, I'm going to be using ZADB as my database. So I created this empty directory. So from the command prompt, I'm going to cd to my MongoDB bin directory. And I'm gonna be starting MongoDB, so MongoD, and the DB path, the database that I'm gonna be using is this ZADB. So here we go. So it's running and it's listening on port 27017. So after I started it, should have some files here in the database directory. So next, let me open up a new command prompt, and I'm gonna cd to the bin directory and start mongo. Now I'm gonna do use admin, and I'm gonna add the VA user with the password of password, so db.addUser. Now here in my driver class, in main, I'm gonna start by picking up the Mongo client with so it's gonna go to localhost, the port is 27017, and it's gonna pick up the database ZADB. And I'm gonna be needing to read the username and the password and various commands from the command prompt. To do that, I'm gonna pick up a buffered reader instance by passing an input stream instance, which takes in a system.in. And I'm gonna create an authenticate method, which is gonna take the DB instance and the buffered reader instance as parameters. So it's gonna make it, I'm gonna make it static and private, and it's gonna return boolean depending on if that user authenticated or not. I'll initialize a flag as true and return that flag. The first thing I'm gonna do is to ask that user for their username and go ahead and read that username using the buffered reader instance. And I'll do the same for the password. So I'll ask that user for the password and read the password using the buffered reader. And next, I'm gonna try to authenticate using the username and the password, and do password to char array, pass it to the to this authenticate method on the DB instance. And I'm gonna check if it returns true. I'm gonna proceed otherwise. Gonna indicate that it is an invalid username or password, and I'm gonna set the flag to false and return afterwards. Now if this returned true, I'm gonna go ahead and pick up the table channel, the channel table, and so if it does not exist, it's gonna get created. And then go into loop, into a loop asking the user what they want to do. So while true, I'm gonna ask the user what you want to do, and then store it in a command, which is gonna be a string I'm gonna define here. So one possibility is that the user wants to exit, so they enter exit and I break if they do that. Otherwise, for the purpose of this tutorial, I'm gonna have two other options. One of them is find all, and it's gonna return all the records in that table. So I'm gonna define the find all method. And let's say the other option is that they want to insert JSON as data. So I'm gonna have an insert JSON method. It's gonna take in the buffered reader instance and the DB collection, the table. So for find all, I'm gonna first pick up a DB cursor. I'm gonna call on this DB collection, on the channel DB collection, I'm gonna call the find method without passing anything, which is gonna give me back all the records in there, which I'm gonna go ahead and print them all. So I'm gonna do dbcursor.next as long as there is other records, and print some. Now as far as inserting JSON, I'll first prompt the user to enter the JSON data, and then I'm gonna read that entered data, and gonna call the parse method on JSON, the static parse method, and cast what comes back to a DB object. And I'm gonna insert that DB object in the channel DB collection. Okay, next, gonna go back to my main method and gonna set up a flag. Start it as initialize it as false, and I'm gonna let that user attempt to authenticate while that flag is false. I'm gonna send him into a loop, into a while loop. Okay, so let me save all and try to run it. So let me start with a false user. So false user. Invalid username, password. Let's try now a valid user, so ZA user, and the password of password. So let's go back to my command prompt. So when I set up this user, I set it up for the admin, I think. So let me do use DB and then do db.addUser VA user with the password of password. Okay, so now let me stop this one and rerun it. So the user, let's invalid user, start with that first, and now if I do VA user and password of password, okay, so I got into this loop, so I did authenticate. So I'm gonna try to insert the record in there as JSON data. So let me say insert JSON, and gonna have this JSON data. So the name, the channel, and the subscriptions, and have a couple, the name each, and number of views. Okay, so assuming it inserted, so so next what I'm gonna try to do is to call the find all to see if it is gonna return that record. Okay, so it returns that record. So next, let me go ahead and exit.